Hello, guys and gals, and welcome to another episode of Unique Items. Today, we're going to be going over a pair that I've already gone over, which is the gloves called Goer's Devastating Grips. Goer's Devastating Grips have seen a lot of changes, and I believe the first time I made this video, I said Goer's Devastating Grips has seen a lot of changes. Well, now they've seen even more changes. Let's go over the new version of them. So this is the version 1.20 Goer's Devastating Grips, and let's talk about how they currently function. So Goer's Devastating Grips is an ancestral unique item. I believe it can also drop in Sacred. It's a pretty decent little kit now that they've kind of modified it a little bit. And let's go upgrade it so we can get the tier 5 stats. Faster, barbarian. Faster. It's right.
That looks worn. I can fix it.
Boop, 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 boop. So right off the bat, you'll see we have 19.5% damage increase, which does vary between 15.8 and 26.2%. So I got a pretty low roll. 7.5% critical strike chance against close enemies, which rolls from 4.5 to 12. 12% would be a hell of a lot better. Mine was pretty terrible. And honestly, if you're whirlwinding or whatever, like against close enemies, they're all close. Okay, you're rollwinding. They're all close. 14.1% lucky hit chance, which does vary from 8.1 to 16.5%. And then 3 to 4 ranks of whirlwind, which I obviously didn't get the highest one there. Whirlwind is the main skill that these are geared towards. So, of course, you want the higher skills. It also has the special effect. Now, the special effect has been changed considerably from previous versions, and a whirlwind explodes every 2 seconds after it ends, dealing 24%, 16 to 26% of the base damage dealt to surrounding enemies as fire damage. Now, what they did is they actually removed the attack speed off of these because they realized that attack speed basically had no connection to whirlwind. It doesn't actually help it at all. And another thing that they did is they kind of prevented people from being able to like store up the charges. So whirlwind is just going to explode every 2 seconds. That's basically how it's going to work now. It doesn't matter how many enemies you hit, whether it's 1 or 300, it's going to explode every 2 seconds and it's going to dish out 26% of its base damage as fire damage to all surrounding enemies. Now I could take you out there and go play around with this real quick. Why not? And I'll show you how it works now versus how it used to work. Oh, I already got Whirlwind. Let's just drag it down then. That's right, because it actually gives you the skill. Oh yeah, I need a generator. Hold on.
Need more time.
We got no monsters out here. This is barren as a desert. All right. So let's go ahead and, this is not my main spec, by the way, so don't laugh at me if I die here. Let's go ahead and build up my doojank so that I actually have some to spend here. This guy is messing with my feng shui over here. Looks like he's got my build running. Alright. So now how it works is that when you whirlwind, it causes the explosion to happen once every 2 seconds. So you notice that every 2 seconds, there's just a fire explosion that comes out. And obviously, this is both good and bad. Because the way that they have it set up is they have it set up so it doesn't really matter how many monsters you hit. Or whether you stop whirlwinding or something like that. It's pretty much just as soon as it hits 2 seconds, it's immediately... Ooh, nice little four ring of the umbral. I like that. Oh, this is a hell tide. Let me get out of here. Punk. This is my frenzy barbarian. He's not a whirlwind barbarian. He's a frenzy barbarian. And that's why I murdered that monster with my friends there. Overall, though, I do think that Goer's Devastating Grips are in a better place than when they first started. But I'm not entirely sure that I would want to use them myself. It's one of those items that is built around Whirlwind. Whirlwind is a channeling skill. Unfortunately, channeling skills cannot overpower. They also cannot be affected by attack speed. And unfortunately, due to the nature of channeling skills tend to be the odd man out in terms of damage output. I'm not sure exactly what they could potentially do about Whirlwind being a channeling skill and potentially fixing it overall. But one thing that I think that they could do is they had actually capped out the explosion. So like the number of times that you attack targets builds up the damage up to a certain percentage. They could uncap it now. I think that would be perfectly fine. I'm really kind of confused, honestly, on what they could do to make these worthwhile. And it's not necessarily, I think, because Whirlwind is, or these are bad gloves, or they're set up badly. I think it's just because Whirlwind itself isn't really the best skill in Diablo 4. Much the same way that Whirlwind was kind of the redheaded stepchild of Diablo 2, and often got nerfs when it didn't deserve them, and nerfs when it did deserve them, and back and forth was just always a subject of great criticism from the community and the developers at large. I feel like this item might be doomed to that pit of destruction, which is the skill that has way too much attention focus on it, if that makes any sense. But as they are right now, they're definitely a hell of a lot better than they were in previous iterations. In fact, I think the last video I did on these, they were not anywhere near as good as they are right now. Taking off the attack speed and adding on the crit strike chance, setting them up to be a little bit more useful in general. So if you are a Whirlwind Barbarian, you may want to look into Goer's Devastating Grips, because they do look like they're pretty much like best in slot for you at this point, I think. Anyway, as always, I do appreciate you guys and gals watching my videos. Even when we're just talking about the Brutus construction of these gloves belies the strength they bestow. Goer was clearly no craftsman, but it would be foolish to ignore the triumph of his work, Barrett's Book of Implements. And as always, keep watching.